Hello and welcome. In today's lecture, we'll try to apply the rules of vocabulary, grammar, and style covered in the first lecture. The lecture will deal with some passages from the said book, English texts to be translated into Arabic, our subject, translation into Arabic, together with some other passages. The first passage, Haskins heads task force. Haskins is the name of a person, heads task force. The title, Haskins heads task force. Haskins على رأس فريق المهمات. Or Haskins يرأس فريق المهمات. هنا للمترجم الحرية يقول على رأس أو يرأس أو حتى يترأس فريق المهمات. في التايتل بنحب نفضل إن يكون the title in the brief words, words content words. Haskins heads task force. Heads here is the verb. We read first the passage. Christopher Haskins, a long-time labor supporter and chairman of Northern Foods, is to head the government's task force on better regulation, the successor body to the Conservatives' deregulation unit. The task force will soon appoint a panel of 12 to 15 members who will look at regulation in government departments, corporate governance, the environment, and the regulatory powers of local government. There is no connection with the DTI inquiry into utilities regulation. It's clear that the passage contains some difficult vocabulary. We'll try to shed light on the meanings and their usage together with the structure, as I've just said, of the passage. The first sentence, Christopher Haskins, a long-time labor supporter and chairman of Northern Foods, is to head the government's task force on better regulation, the successor body to the Conservatives' deregulation units. A bit long sentence, starting with the subject, Christopher Haskins is the subject head. What about Christopher Haskins? Some associates, information about Christopher Haskins, our subject. He is a long-time labor supporter. Supporter means مناصر أو يناصر, موالي لي, نصير, مناصر, Labour Party اللي هو حزب العمال, long time, زمنا طويلا أو وقتا طويلا. يبقى هنا كريستوفر هاسكنز هو supposed to be who is, هنا زي zero relative clause, مش محتاج نقول who is a long time Labour supporter and chairman of Northern Foods, هو الذي ظل يناصر حزب العمال لزمن طويل, and chairman of Northern Foods. Chairman دائما بيستخدم رئيس, chairman of the committee. To chair, الverb هو يرأس أو يترأس. To chair the meeting, to chair the committee, to chair the organization, دائما نقول عليه chair زي الheads, the heads. Chairman of Northern Foods ومكتوبة capital letters, ونحس ان الحاجات اللي بتكتب capital letters دي معناها انها the name of a company, name of organization, like this, Northern Foods. All this is about the subject. A long time labor supporter and chairman of Northern Foods. Is to head, the verb in the passage is to head, and is to hear indicates the future. Will head, he's going to head the government's task force on better regulations. This is the object. That is to head the government's task force. Task force معنى فريق المهمات. فريق المهمات الحكومة أو التابع للحكومة. On better regulation المعني بوضع لائحة أفضل. Better regulations أو نظم أفضل. What about what else? The successor body to the conservatives deregulation unit. Deregulation unit وحدة إلغاء القيود. Task force فريق المهمات. Better regulations تنظيم أفضل. The successor body وهو هي الهيئة التي حلت محل. Success here, success is, does not mean verb ينجح in Arabic, but it, does mean, it means يخلف. اللي هو the one who succeeds here بمعنى انه successor الذي يخلف فلان. هنلاقي هنا ان المطول الجملة ديت the subject and its associates, the object and its associates. Christopher Hoskins, a long time labor supporter and chairman of Northern Foods. This is the subject. The translator must include all the associates of the subject in order to include every piece of information. The verb is to head, and as we learned from last lecture, we are supposed to preferably begin with the verb in the Arabic structure in the target language. Preferably, the verbal sentence is common and is used. Is to head the government's task force. فهنا اللي هنبدأ بيها the verb is سيرأس أو سيترأس أو سيكون على رأس. Government's task force on better regulation, the successor body to the conservative deregulation unit. This is the object of the sentence. Look closely at the elements and components of the first sentence, starting with Christopher Hoskins, ending at unit. The subject is Christopher Hoskins. What else? A long time labor supporter الذي ظل يناصر حزب العمل حزب العمال زمنا طويلا. And chairman of Northern Foods ورئيس مجلس إدارة شركة Northern Foods. This is the subject. The verb is to head. This structure of the verb is to head does not mean verb to be in at the present, but it indicates the future. As you see here, نلاحظ أنه يشير إلى حدث مستقبل. The prime minister is to hold a meeting with some government officials and senior other ministers. Is to hold a meeting, is to launch a plan, and so on, بمعنى future. Is to تكرر أن يرأس is to head أو سيرأس وهكذا. The object, the third component of this sentence, the government task force فريق العمل الحكومي أو التابع للحكومة. On better regulations المعني بوضع تنظيم أفضل. On better regulation the successor body وهي الهيئة التي حلت محل to the conservatives deregulation unit وحدة إلغاء القيود التي أنشأها حزب المحافظين. الفوكابلري في الباسج صعب شوية لكن أنا أكتر من الفوكابلري يهمنا إزاي جبت ترجمة الباسج ديت التارجت لانجو إزاي عملناها. المفعول هنا object بتاعنا the government task force الحاجات دي كلها عليه اللي هو فريق العمل الحكومي on better regulation طبعا هنا في الكومبوننتس بتاعه associates of the object given in detail the successor body to the conservatives deregulation units كلمة conservatives conservative party and حزب المحافظين nature conservation or environment conservation الحفاظ على البيئة وتكون هنا الترجمة بتاعتها في الـ first sentence تكرر أن يرأى بس هنا تكرر past نعم بس with future implication or indication تكرر أن يرأس كريستوفر هاسكنز الذي ظل يناصر حزب العمال زمنا طويلا ورئيس مجلس إدارة شركة Northern Foods فريق العمل الحكومي المعني بوضع تنظيم أفضل وهي الهيئة التي حلت محل وحدة إلغاء القيود التي أنشأها حزب المحافظين. Important is the fact is the structure and equally important is the vocabulary. The second sentence, the task force ending at local governments. نشوف الجملة ديت في التكست. The task force will soon appoint a panel of 12 to 15 members who will look at regulation in government departments, the corporate governance, the environment, and the regulatory powers of local governments. نلاحظ هنا برضو المكون the components of the sentence. The subject is the task force. The task force. The verb is will soon appoint. Will soon appoint. Will soon appoint. This is the verb. It's underlined in the text. Will soon appoint a panel of 12 to 15 members who will look at regulations in government departments, corporate governance, the environment, and the regulatory powers of local governments. If the beginning is with the verb, will soon appoint, سيعين أو سيقوم بتعيين, سيعين فريق المهمات, a panel of لجنة of 12 to 15 members, نجيب مكونة من عندنا, هنقول لجنة من ممكن, لكن لجنة مكونة من 12 إلى 15 عضوا, who will look at regulation, وهنا في زي embedded clause على الobject بتاعنا, members who will look at regulation in government departments, وهؤلاء الأعضاء سيقومون بالنظر في النظم في هيئات الحكومة, departments ساعات بتعني وزارات, state departments اللي هي تعني state department, وزارة الخارجية الأمريكية US state department, ما ننساهاش US state department, وdepartments تعني حقوق تعني بيها وزارات, وزارة الخارجية الأمريكية US state department. وبالمرة بقى US secretary of state اللي هو وزيرة الخارجية الأمريكية هي كوندوليزا رايس, US secretary of state ملوش foreign minister but secretary of state. The constituents of this sentence in details the task force, فريق مهمات أو فريق العمل, will soon appoint is the verb, a panel of 12 to 15 members, and there is a relative clause embedded sentence, who will look at regulation in government departments, سيقومون بالنظر في القواعد السارية في هيئات أو في المصالح الحكومية أو الوزارات في بريطانيا. Corporate governance, إدارة الشركات. And the regulatory powers of government, السلطات التنظيمية للحكومة. هنا كلمة powers, هون اتعودنا خلاص على كلمة regulations دايما كلمتين بيجوا مع بعض. Rules and regulations, نظم واللوائح. Rules and regulations, you got to follow the rules and regulations. The regulatory powers, regulatory here is the adjective from regulations or regulate. Powers does not mean قوة but means سلطات here. It's often used as سلطات. When you say new powers will be given to the government under which it will try to impose a ban on whatever the imports of poultry. For example, considering the bird flu, powers here, powers ما تعني السلطات, ونخلي بالنا باستخدامها كتير قوي بمعنى سلطات. طبعا ليها معاني كتير قوي, في look it up in an English dictionary finds so many meanings for power. تتكون الترجمة تكون زي سيقوم فريق العمل على الفور بتعيين بعض المترجمين او في اتجاه الترجمة ما نستخدمش سيقوم كتير, ولكن ممكن هو طبعا في يعني استخدام its in use ممكن نستخدم على طول سيعين فريق العمل على الفور لجنة مكونة, لكن هنا سيقوم فريق العمل على الفور بتعيين two particles of the verb, parts of the verb, سيقوم بتعيين ما نقدرش نجيب مع بعضها, سيقوم فريق العمل على الفور بتعيين لجنة مكونة من 12 إلى 15 عضوا للنظر في النظم المعمول بها في المصالح الحكومية في بريطانيا, وإدارة الشركات والبيئة والسلطات التنظيمية للحكم المحلي. نعم, the vocabulary needs considering, memorizing, spelling, of course focus on spelling, especially spelling mistakes, many multisyllabic words like governance, departments, environment, regulatory, governance, environment, كلمة environment ما ننساهاش, environment يعني البيئة. شفنا هنا كلمة will soon appoint وسيعين ممكن من للمترجم الحق انه هو يقول يحول الفيرب الى نون، بدل ما يقول سيعين او سينظر فيه نقول سيقوم بتعيين او سيتولى تعيين، سيتولى التعيين او سيقوم بالنظر فيه. هنا ما فيش مشكله في ان احنا نحول appoint and look at into nouns in the target language and of course vice versa. But important is the fact that we have to have a parallel structure. That is, if we say تعيين, we got to mention نظر فيه. If they are two, they have two nouns or two verbs, يعين and ينظر فيه. قلنا يؤدي ويجدد، يؤدي أداء تجديد. Nouns, nouns. This is parallel structure in the two languages. The third sentence, the third sentence, but the shortest actually. There is no connection with the DTI inquiry into utilities regulation. There is no connection with the DTI. That is, there is no connection between what is the previous point and what's going on in the DTI. That is the Department of Trade and Industry in England. The DTI inquiry, اللي هو التحقيق الجاري into utilities. كلمة utilities تعني بيها المرافق. Regulation. وهتيجي معانا كمان كلمة infrastructure وتعني بيها البنية التحتية. Infrastructure يستخدم كثيرا. Utilities اللي هي المرافق. هنا هنرجع للجملة الأخيرة وترجمتها. الجملة الأخيرة في عندنا نشوف الفوكابلري الأول بتاعها DTI Department of Trade and Industry وزارة التجارة والصناعة. Inquiry تحريات فحص تحقيق. Utilities المرافق العامة. Infrastructure البنية التحتية. لما يكون في زي DTI ما تخافوش الحقيقة مش يجي يعني abbreviations or acronyms إلا ما تكون في مفصلة بس إلا الحاجات المشهورة like UN United Nations كلنا عارفين the USA United States of America WHO this is famous enough World Health Organization حتى دي برضو بنقدر it's mentions World Health Organization so the initials or acronyms of bodies United Nations bodies or world organizations like World Bank or International Monetary Fund IMF or FAO منظمة الأغذية والتجارة Food and Agriculture Organization. Don't worry about this, but you have them written in full words, but then please give special consideration and attention to the acronyms. That is, for example, United Nations, PM, Prime Minister, MP, commonly used in the media. PM means Prime Minister, MP, Member of Parliament. Like this, the National Democratic Party, NDP, National Democratic Party, like this. وتكون الترجمة في النهاية الجملة الثالثة ليس هناك علاقة. There is no connection or صلة. ممكن تقول علاقة، ممكن تكون صلة نوع من الربط بين ذلك. What is ذلك? Or what has gone previously? Preceded this sentence والتحقيقات التي تجري في وزارة التجارة والصناعة بشأن القواعد السرية للمرافق العامة. لو في this is a bit difficult translation but the structure is the most conspicuous aspect in this passage. In the second passage of course we find it's far less difficult in the meanings and in the other passages we try to apply the rules of the semantics, the syntax and stylistics to the passages given below. Food for All, our second passage, number two today. Food for All is the crucial problem of the world today for several reasons. A hungry world is never likely to be a peaceful world. It's not saying too much to suggest that unrest throughout the world most frequently has its root cause in dissatisfaction with that part of the standard of living concerned with food. As Lou Groclark has put it, stable civilization will be built only on the foundations of the farm and the kitchen. We do well to remind ourselves that we consume food for many reasons. A large part of the food we eat keeps us going by providing the body with its heat and energy. It has precisely the same function as fuel performs with our modern machinery. A bit long sentence, text, but it's much easier than the first one. Food for All here means the title for everybody. توفير الطعام للجميع او طعام لكل فم، الطعام للجميع. هنا ليها اكتر من ترجمه هنشوفهم مع بعض. The first sentence, food for all, is the crucial problem of the world today for several reasons. A hungry world is never likely to be a peaceful world. First two sentences. The opening sentence, food for all, is the crucial problem of the world today for several reasons. يعد توفير الطعام للجميع أو الطعام لكل فم مشكلة عصيبة تواجه عالم اليوم لعدة أسباب. لعدة أسباب. For several reasons. ممكن نقول توفير الطعام لكل فرد، لكل فم. هنا يختلف المترجم فيها ومش هتبقى مشكلة في صياغات متعددة. ما يبقاش في صياغة fixed just one and or hard and fast rules to be applied and that's all. You may have variations or correct varied translation for one passage. As long as the meaning or the news is conveyed, that's honestly, so no problem with the phrasing. Food for all is the crucial problem of the world today for several reasons. توفير الطعام لكل فم تعد مشكلة عصيبة تواجه عالم اليوم لعدة أسباب. A hungry world is never likely to be a peaceful world. A hungry world is never likely to be a peaceful world. Is never likely is the verb to be a peaceful world. هنا فلا يمكن فلا يحتمل وليس من المحتمل ليس من المحتمل أن يسود السلام عالم جائع أو أن ينعم عالم يعاني من الجوع أو يتدور جوعا من ينعم بالسلام. يسود السلام peaceful وجبنا ينعم به أو جبت يسود ينعم به أو يسود به يسود منين كلمة peaceful peaceful world هو عالم مسالم بس هو يقصد به أن peace when peace dominates this world. النص ده يقصد به أنه peaceful world that peace prevails or dominates the world. فلا يمكن أو ليس من المحتمل أن يعم السلام عالم يعاني من الجوع. وهنا نحتاج linkage sort of linkage بين الجمل في اللغة الإنجليزية. ما نحاولش ان احنا we don't just have to stop at the first stop in Arabic. هنا الصياغة العربية بتحتاج نوع من الكوهيجن وهنا و at the conjunction أداة التعقيد زي فا من ثم وحيث حيث أن وهكذا. طبعا don't force them but try to come up with a sort of cohesion and with cohesive ties to smooth the translation and to have it to be readable enough and easy enough for the readers. For food for all is the crucial problem. دي خلاص ال two sentences دول. It's not saying too much to suggest that unrest throughout the world most frequently has its root cause in dissatisfaction with that part of the standard of living concerned with food. It's not saying too much. ليس من المبالغة في شيء. It's not exaggeration. كلمة مبالغة. Exaggeration. Saying too much to exaggerate means to exaggerate. E-X-A-G-G-E-R-A-T-E. To suggest أن نقول that unrest, state of unrest, تعني حالة القلق، حالة عدم الاستقرار هنا state of instability, unrest, disorder throughout the world most frequently has its root cause in dissatisfaction with that part of the standard of living concerned with food. Root cause, the main cause or key cause, سبب الرئيسي. وهنا تعني وليس من المبالغة في شيء أن نقول بأن حالة القلق التي تسود العالم أو التي تجتاح العالم تجتاح ربوع العالم throughout the world حسب ما ترجمها في أكثر من صيغة يرجع سببها الرئيسي في عدم الارتياح أو عدم الرضا عن مستوى المعيشة الذي يتعلق بالطعام أو الذي يكون على أساس الطعام أو توفير الطعام. هنا هنشوف الترجمة مكتوبة بس نكمل. As Logro Clark has put it, هنا we have a quotation. As Logro Clark has put it, in quotation between inverted commas, stable civilization will be built only on the foundations of the farm and the kitchen. This quotation supports, reinforces the meaning of the first, the previous part. Gro Clark has put it. وكما عبر عنها كلمة put هنا مش وضعها ممكن عبر عنها أحسن حاجة as he expressed كما عبر عنها أعرب عنها وصفها كلمة put هنا مش معنى يضع كما وكما عبر عن ذلك وكما وعبر Gro Clark عن ذلك ب ونكتب الكوتيشنز كما هي stable civilization حضارة مستقرة will be built only on the foundations of the farm and the kitchens. هنا نقدر السياق هنا نترجمه إلى اللغة العربية لا يمكن أن تقوم حضارة مستقرة إلا على أسس المزرعة والمطبخ. This is his point of view, the quite economic point of view, where civilization and the state of stability is closely associated with the economic conditions. Farm and the kitchen. Gro Clark has put it this way. Stable civilization will be based or built only on the foundations of the farm and the kitchen. وكما عبر عن ذلك Gro Clark بقوله أنه لا يمكن أن تبنى حضارة مستقرة إلا على أسس المزرعة والمطبخ. نقفل الكوتيشنز. We have to close the inverted commas. We carry on with the passage. We do well to remind ourselves that we consume food for many reasons. A large part of the food we eat keeps us going by providing the body with its heat and energy. It has precisely the same function as fuel performs with the same. It has precisely the same function as fuel performs with our modern machinery. We do well to remind ourselves that we consume food for many reasons. فلنفعل خيرا لأنفسنا إذا ذكرناها دائما. هنا كلمة remind يذكر مش there is a difference between remind and remember. Sometimes it's taken for or mistaken for remember. When you remember something معنى يتذكر. Remember the names, remember the details, remember the dates. But please remind me of something means remind me of the dates, remind me of the appointment. بمعنى إنك تذكرني بي. يذكر بي غير يتذكر. يذكر remind of something. That verb A transitive. But remember verb intransitive. يتذكر. We do well to remind ourselves that we consume food for many reasons. فلنفعل خيرا لأنفسنا إذا ذكرناها عندما نتذكر بأننا نستهلك الطعام لعدة أسباب. Consume food for many reasons. A large part of the food we eat keeps us going by providing the body with its heat and energy. فجزء كبير من الطعام الذي نتناوله يمدنا بالطاقة والحرارة اللازمة. لأجسامنا. Providing the body with its heat and energy. It has precisely it هنا الضمير it means what refers back to the food we eat. It has precisely the same function as fuel performs with our modern machinery. فالطعام على وجه الدقة أو بالتحديد أو الطعام يؤدي بالتحديد نفس الوظيفة ونفس يقوم بنفس الأداء ونفس المهمة أو الوظيفة التي يؤديها الوقود في الماكينات أو الآلات الحديثة. It has precisely the same function as fuel performs with our modern machinery. Closer look at the vocabulary. Crucial, peaceful world is never likely, not saying too much or not exaggerating, unrest, state of unrest, the trab or colic, sort of disorder, frequently, root cause, dissatisfaction with, note here the root of the verb is satisfy, to be satisfied with, but the prefix is this, and the noun suffix chin, dissatisfaction with, standard of living, concerned with, stable civilization, foundations, remind of something, consume, the opposite of which is produce. And please consider the other derivatives of the verb consume and produce. For consume, we have consumer, consumption, istihlak, produce, producer, production, there's also productivity, and so on. Ala wajh dikku, precisely or accurately, function, modern machinery, here the first sentence, you have this the translation of the passage available on the website. Food for all is the crucial problem of the world today for several reasons. A hungry world is never likely to be a peaceful world. You find it complete translation. توفير الطعام لكل فم أو الطعام للجميع يشكل مشكلة عصيبة لعالم اليوم لعدة أسباب. فإنه لا يمكن أن يعم السلام عالما يعاني من العالم يعاني من وطأة الجوع. It's not saying too much to suggest that unrest throughout the world most frequently has its root cause in dissatisfaction with that part of the standard of living concerned with food. ترجمنا هذا this part, we have translated this part fully. Now move on to another passage and another issue, quite different issue, that is of the nuclear issue of Iran. Iran is related to Iran's nuclear program, as you have heard in the news that there is a row, political row or standoff between Iran and the nations of the world, particularly the United States, many nations, great powers. The row is over Iran's political nuclear program. On the one hand, Iran insists to carry on with its nuclear program and activities, enriching uranium, as they say, for peaceful purposes, for generating electricity for industry, but the United Nations and the opposition nation, many nations oppose this idea and this program of Iran, and maintain the view that Iran is developing its nuclear program in order to develop a nuclear weapons. And this way, Iran poses a threat to the whole world. If Iran's program of enriching uranium and providing nuclear fuel for nuclear technology and nuclear weapons, this would jeopardize the peace of the world, as the United States claims and maintains. Here we have two passages concerned with the Iran's issue. US condemns Iran, first one, US condemns Iran nuclear advance. US condemns Iran nuclear advance. The United States has said Iran is moving in the wrong direction after its announcement that it has successfully enriched uranium. Iran's President Mohammad Ahmadinejad said Iran had become the latest nation with nuclear technology. The US said defiance of UN calls to cease nuclear activities isolated Iran and its people. Meanwhile, Russia urged Tehran to stop all enrichment work. The head of the UN's nuclear watchdog is due in Tehran to discuss the crisis. The title is US condemns Iran nuclear advance. كلمة verb condemn بمعنى يدين أو تنتقد تشجب. US condemns Iran nuclear Iran's nuclear advance. It means advance here development. Iran تطوير إيران لبرنامجها للنووي. The United States has said Iran is moving in the wrong direction. This is quoted. The United States has said Iran is moving in the wrong direction after its announcement that it has successfully enriched uranium. The vocabulary. Iran's President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad said Iran had become the latest nation with nuclear technology. The US said defiance of UN calls to cease nuclear activities isolated Iran and its people. Meanwhile, Russia urged Tehran to stop all enrichment work. The head of the UN's nuclear watchdog is due in Tehran to discuss the crisis. Now the vocabulary condemns. The verb condemn means يدين يشجب. Nuclear advance. Words here related to nuclear technology, technology النووية, nuclear enrichments, التخصيب, nuclear activities, الأنشطة النووية, nuclear program, and so on, nuclear weapons, of course, أسلحة نووية. طبعا أهم من أهم الكلمات اللي هي فيها دي اللي بتتعلق بالملف الإيراني, طبعا الوكالة الدولية للطاقة الذرية, دي Nuclear Atomic Energy Agency, Nuclear Atomic, the Atomic Energy Agency. It condemns nuclear advance, announcement, إعلان, enriched uranium, أو خسارة اليورانيوم, تخصيب اليورانيوم, defiance, أو تحدي, calls in the at, cease, توقف, stop, hold, يتوقف, again, we have two verbs other than stop, دائما verb stop يعني توقف, لكن في كلمتين تانيين بيستخدموا طول الوقت في السياسة, very much in use and in common, cease and hold, hold the nuclear program, or cease its nuclear activities, أنشطتها النووية, activities هي جاية أنشطة, watchdog, هيئة الرقابة على الأسلحة النووية. كلمة watch dog هنا, dog has nothing to do with the dog, the word dog. The watch dog is means هيئة الرقابة. Urged means called for or hasset. Crisis is أزمة, but here the plural of crisis is, the plural of crisis is crises. Crises. Plural of crisis is crises, like the plural of analysis, analyses. So please consider the vocabulary, the plural of crisis, crises, like analysis. Back to the translation of the passage about the political row over Iran's nuclear program. The United States has said Iran is moving in the wrong direction after its announcement that it has successfully enriched uranium. The best translation for said is either صرح or أكد. When it's mentioned the first time, it's said means صرح. It's better than declared and announced. Say it's صرح. Said. أحسن من قال. صرحت الولايات المتحدة بأن إيران تسير في الاتجاه المعاكس أو المخالف الاتجاه الخطأ، وذلك بعد إعلانها بأنها قد نجحت في تخصيب اليورانيوم. Try to apply the syntactic rules that of structures the United States has said. United States, the subject, has said the verb here. The has said the sentence, embedded sentence. Iran is moving in the wrong direction. Iran is moving in the wrong direction. If we consider the news here, Iran is moving in the wrong direction. So Iran is the subject, is moving, the verb in the wrong direction is preposition. But the head of the subject, the subject of the sentence, the United States, has said the main verb, has said Iran is moving in the wrong direction after its announcement that it has successfully enriched uranium. Successfully here is an adverb. And the adverb describes the verb, has enriched uranium successfully, but here not the position of the adverb, successfully enriched uranium. Iran's president Mahmoud Ahmadinejad said Iran had become the latest nation with nuclear technology. وصرح الرئيس الإيراني محمود أحمدنيجاد بأن إيران قد أصبحت آخر دولة تمتلك تكنولوجيا نووية. وصرح الرئيس الإيراني محمود أحمدنيجاد بأن إيران قد أصبحت آخر الدول التي تمتلك أسلحة تكنولوجيا نووية. latest nation هنا دائما نقول latest developments بمعنى التطورات الأخيرة، يعني تعلن على أن كونها آخر دولة أو أحدث دولة، آخر دولة يتم إعلانها أنها تمتلك تكنولوجيا نووية. The US said defiance of UN calls to cease nuclear activities isolated Iran and its people. Meanwhile, Russia urged Tehran to stop all enrichment work. The head of the UN's nuclear watchdog is due in Tehran to discuss the crisis. Defiance means تحدي هنا خرق. في كلمات كتير قوي لكلمة خرق like violation, breach. Defiance هنا بمعنى تحدي. To defy, the verb is defy, D-E-F-Y. The US said defiance of UN calls to cease nuclear activities isolated Iran and its people. وقد صرحت الولايات المتحدة بأن تحدي أو خرق أو الخروج على مطالب الأمم المتحدة بوقف الأنشطة النووية قد عزل إيران وشعبها. هنا defiance of UN call كلمة call please look it up and especially call for and call upon معنى يطالب ويدعو إلى. هنا طبعا نداءات call a meeting يدعو إلى انعقاد. Isolated to isolate something or somebody or some organization or country means تعزل. The word isolation يعني العزلة. Meanwhile Russia urged Tehran to stop all enrichment work. The head of the urged Tehran to stop all enrichment work. And meanwhile means at the same time could can be translated into في غضون ذلك في تلك في نفس الوقت في غضون ذلك قد طلبت أو حثت روسيا طهران على وقف نشطها في تخصيب اليورانيوم enrichments. Last sentence of the passage, the head of the UN's nuclear watchdog is due in Tehran to discuss the crisis. هنا كلمة head طبعا شفناها في Haskins is to head the government task force, first passage of today. Head here as a noun, في head as a verb, is to head, but here it's head as a noun, the head. The head of the department means رئيس القسم, the head, that chair, the chairman or chairperson, the head of the president, the head of the president or the head of the government, the head of the UN's nuclear watchdog is due in Tehran to discuss the crisis. هو إذ ومن المقرر أو وسيرأس رئيس هيئة الرقابة على الدولية على الأسلحة النووية، سيصل إلى طهران لمناقشة الأزمة. إيز ديو هنا بالضبط زي باسج نمبر 2 لما خدنا إيز 2 أو هاسكنز إيز 2 فيرست باسج، معنى إيز ديو إن من المقرر أن يصل رئيس هيئة الرقابة على الأنشطة النووية التابعة للأمم المتحدة إلى طهران لتناول الأزمة أو لمناقشة الأزمة. Another passage related to the nuclear issue, about the nuclear issue of Iran and the nuclear issue of the whole world, nuclear weapons. It's a matter of great concern. There are many concerns about the development of nuclear weapons the world over. Can they be stopped? The title is given in the form of a question. Can they be stopped? And in translation, we can keep the form of the question in the in the translation into the target language. الأسلحة النووية هل يمكن وقفها؟ Sort of thing of like this. هل can they be stopped? هل يمكن إيقافها؟ Nuclear technology is now so widespread that it's only political will which stops many countries from making nuclear weapons. محمد البرادعي head of the International Atomic Energy Agency اللي قلنا عليها المنظمة اللي هي International Atomic Energy Agency its acronym IAEA the most well-renowned, most renowned organization nowadays, that of headed by Professor Mohammed Al-Baradei, a Nobel Peace Laureate, recently has won Nobel Prize for Peace. Dr. Mohammed Al-Baradei, head of, is the head of the International Atomic Energy Agency, IAEA. ياريت نعرف هنا IAEA what it stands for, the International Atomic Energy Agency. بناخد initials of International I, Atomic A, Energy E, Agency A. So it becomes IAEA. Said recently that 40 countries could make the bomb if they wanted to. The reason for this is that the technology legally used to enrich uranium to make fuel for nuclear power can easily be developed to make material for nuclear weapons. A country could do this in secret or withdraw from the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, another nuclear terminology, Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty, its acronym NPT, and do it anyway. Non-Proliferation Treaty. معاهدة منع انتشار أو وقف انتشار الأسلحة النووية. So we have now two, one organization that is of the International Atomic Energy Agency, الوكالة الدولية للطاقة الذرية، وعندنا كمان المصطلح الثاني للنيوكلير Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty ومعاهد اسمها معاهدة انتشار منع انتشار الأسلحة النووية Non-proliferation اللي هو منع تقاصر أو انتشار. And نقرأ الباراجراف الأخير. Country could do this in secret or withdraw from the Nuclear Non-proliferation Treaty NPT and do it anyway. This is the Achilles heel of the NPT, an agreement designed to stop the spread of nuclear weapons while allowing countries access to nuclear power. But even if only one or two of them go nuclear, it could bring tension and even war into their regions. Here, I just read out the whole passage for some students, some ask me to focus on pronunciation of especially of multi-syllabic words like non-proliferation, international, uranium enrichment, and so on. Now the translation and the structure. First, the vocabulary: nuclear weapons, widespread. It's an adjective. Widespread use of mobile phones as an adjective. Political will. Will here does not mean will here is a noun. Political will. Willpower means al-irada, قوه الاراده. Willpower. Will لها معاني اخرى. Please look it up. لان ممكن تعني بمعنى هنا كلمه will بس مش كل will يبقى معناها will do, will come as an auxiliary verb future, but it's political will here, it means الاراده. كلمه will الاراده political طبعا سياسيه. There is a third meaning for will, an important meaning that is that means الوصية اللي تركها الميت. Will, that's political will. IAEA, الوكالة الدولية للطاقة الذرية. Enrich uranium or enriching uranium or enrichment of uranium. NPT, the acronym for non-proliferation treaty اللي احنا قلنا عليه. Withdraw لينسحب. Pull out, there is one word for pull out for the troops. Israelis pull out from the West Bank. Achilles heel. This is it's a Greek mythology, but it's introduced into English to mean and to be translated into a weakness, sort of نقطة ضعف أو ثغرة. يعني Achilles heel. Access, a very important word in English. Access, and the verb of which is access. This is it's used as a verb as well, but access is the noun, the most in common. Tension, to have access to something means to have something to be available, to have, for example, an access to the internet, to have an access to the library, to have access to public amenities, and so on. Accessible is the adjective of accessible. Drinking water and drainage are accessible in most of the villages of Egypt. Tension, the adjective of which is tense. The translation of the passage: nuclear technology is not so widespread that it's only political will which stops many countries from making nuclear weapons. The sentence nuclear and ends at weapons. Include the structure: so widespread that means so, adjective that. Please give special attention, pay special attention to this structure, and you have many sentences following this so adjective that. The translation of the passage is included in the said book, and the translation of the first sentence, أصبحت التكنولوجيا النووية. There are more than one translation given in the said book. من وسعة الانتشار للدرجة التي لا يمكن أو يتعذر وقفها إلا بالإرادة السياسية وحدها. Nuclear technology is now so widespread that it's only political will which stops many countries from making nuclear weapons. A structure of so adjective that is very important, and you have very more than one sentence. Please have this as an assignment. You will have it on this website. Nuclear technology is now so widespread that it's only political will which stops many countries from making them. He's so rich that he can buy a private plane. بلغ به من الثراء أنه يستطيع شراء طائرة خاصة. He's so poor that he cannot find food and clothing. فقير بالدرجة التي لا يستطيع معها أن يشتري له أو يحضر لنفسه أو يشتري نفسه الطعام والمأوى والملبس وهكذا. هنا محتاجين you need translation of the rest of the sentence together with the passage. And please read more and more and listen to more and more news about the issue of Iran. It's very important. With this point, we come to the end of today's lecture. Thank you very much. Goodbye.